Hey everyone, and welcome back to another edition of Rippin' for Rookies. Today I have a little tutorial video on how to package baseball cards, and the way that I do it seems pretty effective, and basically everything that you're going to need. We have our penny sleeves, which are now 2 pennies a sleeve. We have our top loaders. We've got our painter's tape, which you can pick up for at the dollar store. Of course, you can pick it up for a buck. And I bought this roll probably back in October, and still got a good amount left back on there. You're gonna need some cellophane tape for the packaging to adhere the label to it. Cardboard, which I cut up, and I'm able to get 2 team bags in there and tape it up really nice. We need our bubble mailer, which I bought a lot of these on eBay. I'll put all the prices and everything that I purchased in the description below. Team bag sets, resealable team bag sets. These are 3 3/8 by 4.5. There's different sizes, but I find that the 3 3/8 width works out really well. You can get different heights. I've had 5 5.5 inch heights, but these are 4.5, and they work really well. And scissors. So what I do is, first thing I do is I get my cards that I give away, and I put them all on penny sleeves. No matter what the value, just penny sleeve them up. And the special cards I put in a top loader. Now there's different sizes of top loader. This is just the basics, which are right here. You can pick these up for anywhere from $3 to $5 at your LCS, or you can order them online, but the prices online are absolutely ridiculous. There's different sizes. You put your basic cards in the smallest size, and then you go up for the chrome cards to the next size up. And if you have relics or anything like that, there are bigger ones out there that you can purchase. So what I do is I'll get the cards that were won, and I'll put them in a team bag. It's got a nice little piece right here that you can tear off, and you can seal the bag. So what I'll do is I'll put them in, and we'll seal them up. I'll get the other stack out here. It's usually, in my giveaways, I usually send out 2 team bags. You know, you can get probably about 20 cards in there if you jam them, but I really don't like jamming. I usually put about 15 cards in here, and it holds the top loaders really well. So you just take this seal off right there, and you seal them up, and they're set and ready to go. I'll do the same with the other one. And I always use cardboard. I put these in between 2 pieces of cardboard and tape it up. So we'll get this one set and ready to go. And cardboard I just get from Amazon boxes. We get, you know, all kinds of stuff sent through the mail, and I receive packages and stuff like that. So the boxes that I can't use that are like really flat or something like that, I just cut them apart. And that's where I get my scissors, and I just cut them down into this size. So what I'll do is I'll move this team bag, I'll move the bubble mailer out of the way, and I'll put the cards in here like this, one going that way, one going that way, and then put the other piece of cardboard on top. So now they're, you know, the corners aren't going to get dinged or anything like that. And I take my painter's tape, and I do a little trick which I actually learned from Bud Stoney, is you take your painter's tape and you flip it like this, and you put a little crease in it. And what you do is you're gonna take it from the one side and go like that, okay? So now this side just lifts right up. It's easy to peel off. You don't have to take a knife or a pair of scissors or anything like that. And you know, it saves you from damaging the cards. And I'll do this on 4 sides. You wanna try to hit the middle of the cards so they don't go sliding out. And you see where the middle spot is right there. And once it's taped, they usually don't slide around too much. And you can kind of put a little pressure on it like that. So right like that, the cards, they're not sliding out. They're in really good shape. We'll do this 2 more times on the ends. And we'll get it packed up and ready to go. The other thing that I did is a few days ago, actually last week, I went online and I purchased a weighing scale from Amazon, and it was only $20. And I was talking to a couple of guys. We were doing a Instagram live feed, and Dave over at Big D's, he said he uses Pirate Ship and he uses it all the time, and it's really inexpensive. I said, all right, let me check it out. So I checked out the website, and it's very simple, and I'm saving anywhere between $1.50 and $2 sending out these packages, and I just started it this week. All right, so I'll give you a little tutorial on that at the end of this video. So the other thing that I do is I've got these index cards, and pick them up for 50 cents for 100 of them. And what I'll do is I'll just write a little note on there. Hey, thank you for, you know, watching my channel. Thank you for your support. Congratulations on winning the team set. So it's all set and ready to go. Now all we have to do is put it in the bubble mailer. You can pick these up relatively inexpensive. I think I got 200, it might have been 100, maybe 200 for like $14. So even at a, you know, 100, it's only 14 cents a piece. I'll just fold it over and put it like that. Now the corner, sometimes it sticks up a little bit. This is where I use the cello tape on it. I'll just put a little bit over the corners so they don't snag or anything like that. Flip that over like that. Flip it over. And I'll do the same for the other side. And then the package is ready to go. A few things that I found that I like and I don't like. I don't like when you get your top loaders and somebody sent it to you and they just put the cellophane tape on it. Just look at that top loader. I mean, is it really worth it for me to scrape all that off and use some rubbing alcohol to get that off to save the top loader? Like, no. I mean, these things can be reused. I reuse them all the time. And, you know, you're just basically wasting it. Also, Scotch tape is another no-no. It's same reason. It just basically destroys the top loader. Don't use that. Just use a little piece of your painter's tape and just put it right over top. It's going to hold the card in. It's going to look nice. It's going to come off and you're not going to have any residue on there. Just like that. So you can reuse the top loader. These things, they're not cheap anymore. I like to reuse and recycle everything I possibly can. So we're all ready to go. The only thing we need to do is put it on the scale, weigh it, and print out the shipping label. And if you want to hang around for the next little tutorial on how to use Pirate Ship, which is really easy, it's free to use. It's not free for the shipping, but it saves you a lot. It saved me, I sent out 3 packages and it saved me $5 already. So, you know, 9 more packages and it was $20, well worth it, and it's paid for itself. So let me get into that. I'll be right back with you. Okay, so now back with Pirate Ship, and very, very easy to use. It's very simplistic. You go online, you just put in pirateship.com, comes up, and all you have to do is set up your account. You put your name, your address, and you need to apply a credit card to it or a bank card to it, and it's very simplistic. And then the next thing, all you have to do is you just need to go to ship. You click on single, you're sending one package, and I'm going to basically send this to myself. There's my address. I don't care if anybody sees it, and has your information down here, who it's sending from. So I'm sending it from me to me. I hopefully this does work and doesn't show you anything. And then types of package. You can go with a box or a rigid package. And then you can go by envelope, padded envelope, poly bag, soft pack, that all goes in there. You got your priority mail, small flat rate box, medium flat rate, large flat rate, and your different types of envelopes, regional boxes, everything is in here that you need. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on the envelope or padded envelope. And then you need to measure it out. So then you need your ruler. and you get your package, and these have usually been right around, you know, 7.5 inches by 7 inches. So this one, as you can see, is 7.5 inches by 7 inches. So what we do is we'll just put that information in there. Let's see, so we'll go 7.5 on here. Bear with me, my computer is very old and it likes to freeze up on me as it's freezing up right now. I don't know, it's got some kind of something on there. And then we'll just go 7.25 on that one. Now, this is where you're going to need your scale. You need to weigh the package. So let me just pop this down here. This is the scale that I purchased from Walmart, or actually Amazon. For $20, and it's perfect. So what you want to do, you just want to make sure you're zeroed out. You want to lift the top of it, and then we're going to weigh it. I might have to move this back a little bit, and it's going to show you how much it weighs. So we're at 4.6 ounces, 4.5. Okay, so we have our weight on there, so we can close up our scale. We don't need this anymore. And we're going to put in the weight below. Let's see, check on. Okay, so weight. So it was, what was that? 4.5 ounces, I believe it was. And I forget already. How about that? So we'll put in the ounces in here. 4.5. It's not going to work. Come on, there we go. 4.5 ounces. So we've got our length, we've got our weight, we've got our ounces, pounds. I just put zero there because it's not over any weight. Custom forms for military, no, we don't need any of that. Hazardous materials, no. Save your settings for repeat use. You can save the package settings if you're sending out to the same people over and over. I know that there's a couple people that I send everything to. Extra services that you can have, signature confirmation. This is all going to cost you extra money. Insurance, you can put insurance on it. If you're sending out a $200 card, why not put some insurance on there? And then you can go down here to get rates, and it'll show you the rates that you can get. I hope this actually works, or I just wasted my time. Okay, so it would have cost me, if I went to the post office, $4.80. It's only going to cost me $3.46 over here. Wow, you can't even see that. So I am sorry about that. So let's go back up to that again. So right here, it shows $4.80 was the original cost, $3.46. So I just saved myself, let's do it in the math in the head right now, $1.38. So it's paying for itself all the time. Ship date, you can put in a ship date that you want to do, and then you click on buy label. Now I'm not going to click on buy label because it's going to charge me to my card. So I don't want to do that because why would I do that? I'm here right now. I don't need to send this package to myself, but that's just a little tutorial on pirate ship. What it'll do is it'll actually print you a label. It's about 5 by 3.5. And what I do is I print it out, I cut it down, I put it on here, and then I use the cellophane tape, and I just put 3 pieces of cellophane tape over top of it to secure it. And therefore it won't get damaged. They'll be able to read it, they'll be able to scan it, and just drop it in a mailbox, and it's ready to go. Well, I hope this was informative to some people. You can save some money out there. I'll put the links below, see if I can still find the links for the bubble mailers and for the penny sleeves. Not the penny sleeves, you can pick them up. You know where to pick them up. But the team bags in the description, also pirate ship, and anything else that you might need to know. All right, everybody, you have yourself a great day. I will talk to you soon. Bye.